Are you struggling with erectile dysfunction? Our friends at Roman can help. Go to getroman.com/holly and get 15% off your first order plus free shipping. That's getroman.com/holly for 15% off your first order plus free shipping.
I am actually surprised that within our podcast, now I'm saying this, we're going to get a million of these. Listeners, do not try to do this. But we actually don't get a lot of dick pics. We don't get a lot of offers from people for sponsorship and things like that. And there's certain times when we've said certain things, such as what I'm saying right now, where all of a sudden we will get a number of them. But we really don't get a ton of it. And when we do, it's just a little entertaining.
We did this contest, this Masturbation May contest. Now, this is last year. We also did one this year. And our poor intern, aka now she's paid, but our executive assistant is the person that handles looking at our DMs. And she goes, I can't unsee what I saw. And I was like, what's happening? So we did, what was the contest?
For Masturbation May,
self-pleasure contest.
The self-pleasure for 30 days, 30-day challenge. And we're recording this during Masturbation May still. It's a way to celebrate self-pleasure. And what we asked them to do is for 10 minutes a day to self-pleasure without any sort of additives, just with their hands, with no goals towards orgasm, just to figure out what their body's like an open exploration. For a lot of folks, they're like, that's going to be easy. And for a lot of folks, like, that's really hard. I'm so used to just giving myself for the orgasm really quickly. And we asked them as part of it to send us a photo of themselves anonymous, holding a piece of paper over their face that said in 10 words or less what they learned, what their experience was. And a lot of people took advantage of that. And they were like, oh, this is an opportunity to send you my DM.
Just after dick pics, after pics. Yeah.
Gonna say probably message over the face, but everything else is exposed.
Yes.
With the phone number, call me.
Yeah. So we're like, oh, you know what? We asked for it though. Like, we didn't directly ask for it, but we kind of did.
But I just felt like a poor executive assistant was just, she...
All the dick shots.
Yeah. So I haven't personally received a lot because I didn't check those.
You are now after this goes on Holly's podcast.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Actually, what's your Instagram?
So it's Holly Randall Unfiltered. You can screen them. And then if it's, you think it's one that we want to see, send it our way.
Yeah, right?
We do like the DX, though.
You know, it's hilarious because my executive assistant actually loves dick pics. And we have this joke where she asks for them a lot. And like, she gets very upset because people don't send them to her.
Oh.
And we do this bonus podcast called My LA Porn Life just on my Patreon. And she's always like, where are the dick pics at? And people will send her like a picture of like Dick Cheney.
Oh,
you know what I mean? Like, to be funny. And she's always like, why don't I get the dick pics? I'm like, I don't know.
The one person asking for them is not getting the dick pics. Because so there's the psychology behind it. Who does it? Justin Lehmiller. I don't know if you've had him on your podcast before, but he was talking about the psychology behind the dick pic. And there is something about the exhibitionist, almost like flashery, you know, you're not expecting it. That it's not for everyone. It. Yeah, you don't want it. So it's a little more exciting and exhilarating versus like, oh, you asked for it? Yeah, it's not as exciting.
I'm an analyzer of all the things except for the dick. So I look at like the background. Holly, maybe you do this because from your photography standpoint, because you talk about lighting, I look at the background. If they're in the bathroom and there's shit all over there, I'm like, oh, no. Not going to happen. I would not be into it. We told you about this when you were on our show, when my current partner had been hooking up with Amy before I ever knew him. And they had hooked up a couple of times. And Amy was also... you were single and having fun, and she was communicating with him, and he sent her a video. Meanwhile, she doesn't really enjoy looking at the dick vids.
I don't mind dick vids or dick pics. I'm not into the actual ejaculation unless it's in person. It's just not my jam over video or photo, but in person with someone I'm intimate with, I think it's super sexy. So it was a video. So I was like, April, you don't know this guy.
Yes. Look at this.
You got to watch it make sure there's no money shot in here because it's not really my jam over video.
So then I watched it and I was like, oh, okay. Okay. I was like, Amy, it's about 8 o'clock at night right now. This is a pre-recorded dick vid because it's daytime.
And he sent this to 80 other people.
Yeah. So, then I sent him back this cat taking a shower. And I said, do you like my wet pussy?
he thinks that was from me, but then it was from her, his future girlfriend. So that was perfect.
Oh my God.
So anyway, that was it.
So when you got together, you already saw his dick.
I did. I told him that. I was like, I already saw your penis. Looks nice.
Very nice.
You know, that's April, I'm so with you on that. Like, if somebody sends me a picture from a messy room
or I see girls post like selfies of them and their house is a mess. It like makes me want to throw up. I'm like, what is wrong with you? Make your fucking bed. Like, cause that's all I see.
Have you ever seen those? I don't know what, who does it. If it's BuzzFeed or some online where they take like the worst selfies ever. And there's like women with like shit in the toilet, like posing and like literally you can see the stuff in the toilet. And there's other ones that a pack of, you know, diapers and a dude like ejaculating. I don't remember what site it was. I saw this a couple of years ago, which I'm like, wait. Yeah, I swear.
What selfie is someone sitting out when there's a dude ejaculating on a stack of diapers in the background? Like, where is this? I need to see this picture.
I just shared a fetish now.
He wasn't thinking. Yeah, it's adult diaper fetish actually was what was really going on.
Some Pampers.
Yeah, they need to take your class, Holly, that you do that?
My workshop.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. They need to take your workshop. You need to help these people out real quick.
I know, right? So have you guys seen those like kind of secret naked selfies where people will take a picture and they'll post it on Craigslist like they're trying to sell the item, like a tea kettle? And if you look carefully at the reflection, it's somebody naked reflected in the tea kettle that you wouldn't catch. Like obviously like a chrome tea kettle, unless you are actually looking.
Are they really trying to sell the tea kettle, or are they trying to flash you?
They're trying to flash you, but in a really subtle way and upload it to, you know, like a website like Craigslist. Well, actually, who knows what you expect on Craigslist, but you know what I mean? Like somewhere where you're not looking for dick pics or expecting to come
creatively
across them.
Would be more of a turn on for me. If someone sent me that,
you're like, brilliant. Sort of, you got me.
I would think about their creativity and their artistic ability and probably be getting a little bit tingly and wet underneath. I'd be like, you took some time.
Yeah.
Like
It's all about the effort, right?
Yeah.
They got you in that one. I'd be like, you know what? It's a little bit like you definitely maybe crossed the boundary because I didn't consent to that, but you got me and that was quite intelligent. Well done.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So really guys, it's about the intelligent dick pics. That's what we're looking for. Just, we don't want the run of the mill, you know, in your bedroom, like kind of dick pics. We'd like something creative.
Yes, please. Thank
you. That's all it comes down to. Have you guys seen that blog, Things My Dick Does?
I don't think
no.
so.
No. Wait, is it
where
the one
guy
he
like draws? Yeah, and he draws on his penis like it's a person.
Yes. Yes.
Like a little stick figure.
I love that.
He like puts it in outfits and stuff like that. It's
adorable.
It is probably one of the most entertaining things for when looking at penises that I've ever seen because the penis will be when it's like he's sick or something and he's like, and he's all slumped over like with like some ejaculate coming out. And then he puts a little hat and like a scarf on him. Aww. And then he will draw a little. Yes, I absolutely. I'm so happy that you.
I wonder what the dick's doing during coronavirus. Bored.
No, probably so much material.
No. I mean, but the actual like setting up what the dick is going through these times.
Many margaritas
on Zoom again. On a Zoom call again.
Do you struggle with ED? You are not alone. If you do, go to GetRoman.com/Holly and meet with a U.S. certified physician, and also get 15% off your first order plus free 2-day shipping. That's GetRoman.com/Holly for 15% off your first order plus free shipping.
Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the show, make sure that you subscribe so you don't miss a single episode. And go check out all the other videos. I film every single one of my podcasts. And if you want to listen to the audio version, I'm on iTunes and all the other podcast platforms. Visit HollyRandallUnfiltered.com to find out more.